standing, look in the mirror, how could you face that? Mask on, don't even know where my face at. Plenty, don't even know where waist at. All these in the room, how could you waste that? Huh? Why would you chase that? It's a never-ending run on this racetrack. No matter what, I'ma stay black. It's a never-ending run on this racetrack. Need more jewelry. What I tell myself as I'm writing my eulogy. Ask the mirror, how you put up with this foolery? In reply, how you put up with this? Put up with this song and dance, all this buffoonery. Long romance, death, what it do to me? Yamagini dream was a nightmare. He was dancing with the devil for his life, yeah. We all on the dance floor. Girl, come with a dance. Puerto Rican. In the even heavy. Little. Am I looking daddy? Couldn't tell him nothing cause we lost him already. Cozy boy with his spaghetti. With the money and fame, the price come heavy. The price come heavy. Like Shaq attack up on a backboard. Gummy back up on a backboard. When she asked me if I love her, I just act bored. Say loser, ask for it.
Living movie, blockbuster. I'm here to remind you where you come from. All this peace retreat is lame done. You can never get rid of me. I'll avenge you. Both of our fire offend you.
Heyo. Oh, another day in Madden Paradise. Oh, come on now, dude. I had to cut so many people at the end of the season for the rule. So. Oh no, come on, dude. You got this. BJ beat me last season with my freaking stack team, so I'm kind of scared to see what will happen against a user with my shit team now. Check y'all in y'all beard. I'm willing to father my peers, all of my peers for all of my years. Out in the field, take a look at my shoes. I know, I hope he's nice to Lamar this game and doesn't hurt him. Never got a tour to it like you. I've been feeling like a king for months. We eat all the rich cuisine for lunch. All these wishing he was done. You can put him back in. Yeah, it's stupid. Now you should get near. Oh, I asked her man, cause I'm the mutant in here. We look good, just show us where the camera. Years ago, I had to up my standards. Make your missus Alabama turn it to my only private. Swear like she don't got the answers. Who's the boss? I feel like Tony Danza. Walk up in there like I got the swag. Wakanda swagger, I'm the blackest panther. Wakanda, y'all are wasting your time. I spend it, but I ain't wasting a dime. Might do some favors, but I ain't breaking my spine. Your girl has been calling for days. I get no different ways. That the world is parades. Yeah, we like. None of my people are patient. We look like we on a vacation. Get no invitation. Y'all all with it and y'all talk a lot, but y'all ain't got the heart to do the mission. Yeah. I'm hard headed like the juggernaut, but there ain't nothing I could do to listen. I'm authentic and I walk around like I got the
Raider. But mix the Autobots and mix with everything that you've been missing. Please get back and don't get that involved. Freaking sick, I need a pad of walls. Mean, I'm the king, heavy cat and dogs. Homie with me if you're asking for it. Oh, come on now. You just want to have a pad of walls. It'll be a good game. Face with little dragon balls. Come on, look, you don't need me either. All I need is this. No coca ice, and I get also polite. You be the man in your city. Yeah, I have to ease into my games. I'll always like start down like 14-0, and it's always just playing catch up at that point. The world is parades. Yeah, we like. None of my people are patient. We look like we on a vacation. Oh shit. Getting on vacation. Yeah, we like. Your girl has been calling for days. I get it in all different ways. Ways. Yeah, I'm like. Oh wow. I love games like that though. Yeah.
convergence.
Well, you won your first game. That's a start.
Art Rooney Drive. We welcome you to Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Oakland Raiders and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
It's good.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
Yeah, I forgot to do that.
And he's not going anywhere to start the night. They stop him at the line of scrimmage.
Mean Joe Green doing his job.
Second down.
Yeah, I had to, man. It was either him or Polamalu.
From the 25 on second and 10.
Get down, get down. Mm-hmm.
To throw on second down, looking for Cooper, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Bud Dupree, and they will take over at the 29-yard line. Cooper was the target there. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Rough start. It's all right. You'll come back.
First drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts.
Hey, it makes you feel any better. Sam Darnold, his first throw was a pick six, and then he went on to win that game like 50-something to 10, so.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest game. It was Joe Hayden, the former Pro Bowler, that came up.
Joe Hayden?
Now.
You have Joe Hayden, too?
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down.
Oh, my
God. A very solid gain on that play.
He went into free agency. They must have just picked him up.
Gone, 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 gone.
Yeah, yeah.
On second down, here's Jackson. Over the middle, hauled in by Smith-Schuster. And he'll get it down this time to the 17.
I can't let you hurt little baby Lamar, man. He's a baby.
First opportunity for the Steelers in the red zone. They've got a first and 10 at the 17.
I know.
Set! Blue 90! Blue 90!
A first carry for the tailback, Devontae Freeman.
Well,
one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down.
I think it's just some random dude I picked up. I could be wrong. I don't know. Yeah, I don't really care about my halfback.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Detroit! Detroit!
Off the play fake. Here's Jackson. He goes underneath to Freeman. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. A great play there from 21 yards away. And the Steelers have taken a first quarter lead.
Hey, did you hear about Crowell, though, in real life?
What's the importance there in the passing game?
Oftentimes yeah. You create mismatches because who's going to cover
him? Oh, no.
And you get him into space,
too soon?
Which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss.
Oh, that's pretty. Dang.
Right after the catch and off he goes.
How does it feel? Like, does it feel any different? After
now a 7-0 game.
You kind of like stretch it out and stuff. Okay. I don't know if Crowell will be able to do that.
Kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line.
They have to when everyone's getting hurt like that.
The Raiders offense now, they trot back out. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I've done that so many. I still do that.
They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Now Carr throwing on second down.
Oh, shoot.
And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. You know, during these preseason games, we're in week 2 right now. It's always funny looking at our spot charts up here in the booth.
Which one?
The guys that might play in
the
this
dude that
one,
tackled him?
It seems to get bigger and bigger each year.
Yeah, we pretty much supersize them, don't we? Because, you know, remember, they're carrying 90 now. And with the new rules, they'll carry 90.
That's that lockdown Steelers D.
Before they make the final cut. Oh, yeah. A lot of guys to learn from these games.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something
that,
here on third
That happens mail. A lot.
Shotgun now for Carr. And this is going to be incomplete.
So now here in the second week of the preseason, you'd expect the starters play a little bit more than they did in week one, but not a whole lot.
So if you're an offensive coordinator, what are you looking for?
What you're looking for is things getting cleaned up as you go along. Because
who the heck is that back there?
How well are they handling
I don't
it?
Know who my punt returner is.
No mental mistakes.
I ain't never seen that name before.
Like a good offensive football team.
O'Donnell, he's on to punt as he gets this one away. Now a fair catch taken.
Oh, dude, he would have got roughed up. He didn't fair catch.
Punt of just 24 yards there. And this offense will take
No.
At the midfield strike with first and 10. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10.
Dude, there's so many times where, like, you don't get the chance to fair catch, and your dude just catches it, it just gets wailed as soon as he catches it.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And this will be taken across midfield and into Raider territory. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
What?
Blue 90! Detroit! Detroit!
Oh, what?
On second down, Jackson. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll go down shy of the
40 off me.
At the 41. It's the first time that they've looked his way.
Dang, dude, you sending that heat?
First down on the play.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
He weighed like 300 pounds. That's not really mobile.
Now a play fake here on first down. He'll buy some time right. And an alley to run.
Oh, why didn't you get down, Lamar? I kept spamming square. He didn't slide. He didn't want to slide. He wanted to take that hit.
With his legs and a first down.
He ain't even on my team no more, man. Oh, God, no. No, no, no.
They'll throw on first down with Jackson. He's got Dallas Goedert, his tight end, over the middle. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays.
Start calling you Kyle with all that heat you're sending, man.
I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
On second down,
there you go.
And he is met quickly in the backfield.
And this dude's trash, man. Who is this man?
Right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Look at that line, dude. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 people in the box.
On third down, it's Freeman, and he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line.
That's what we'd like to see here in the Steelers organization. Yeah, his first rush went for like negative 5. That's all that matters.
Jackson now. And he is caught at the 7-yard line. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Nice job defensively to hold him to 4, and now it's second and goal.
You know, I think we
and the ball
smacked did.
Down on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal.
I know in our first round we picked up a middle linebacker to try and replace Shazier, but I don't know if that'll happen.
He'll get it up the middle.
Yeah!
And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. A great effort there. A 5-yard touchdown.
That's the thing with blitzing, is it like it messes up the running lanes a little bit.
But the intelligence level of the guys up
the gaps block, open up differently line, if it's a blitz versus a just like a 4-man rush or something. I literally never blitz. Like cover 3, cover 2, cover 4, cover 6. That's all you'll see me in.
Setting out to kick this one away and off it goes.
I never blitz.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end.
I ain't giving you a chance, man. That's the last thing I need.
Back on the field. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does. And a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game. And typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points. Get that 0 off the board. Now it's Jackson. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34.
Man, if Bo broke that, I think that would have been 6.
9 yards, and it'll be second down.
He got all the way to the secondary, dude.
Right here.
And nobody even touched him.
But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just get the score.
Yeah.
On second down, here's
I bit.
And Austin Seferian's
good play call.
And he'll be
I totally
right
thought you were
field.
Running that.
The pickup goes for 6.
I bit hard, dude.
Down. He missed on his first 3 passes, was 0-for-3. Now gets a connection. Maybe that'll get him going.
Yeah, it wasn't a time for panic, but there was some concern because once you start in a certain pattern, you're wondering, can you get out of it? And that flips the other way, too, when you're throwing it really well. In this case, now he's got his first completion. They think he might be off to the races.
He runs it this time.
And he'll get this one across midfield and down into Steeler territory.
5 That's my boy right there, number 29.
On first down.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size,
he's replacing Shazier this year.
I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Thank you. You love these two back sets.
To throw on second down, Carr. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. As we thought they might do here in week two of the preseason, they've left their starting quarterback out there for this second quarter. But I would imagine we will not see him after halftime.
Yeah, this is the time of year you've got to get your backup some reps and make sure you protect your starting quarterback.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's some catches like that. Like, I understand if he gets hit stick, like, right when he catches it. But, like, if it's just a regular tackle and he had time to hold on to it, I don't know.
Carr now to throw. And that is incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked.
You can probably make it. If it's telling you to do it, you could probably make it.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Aw. Oh, shit. This is something the NFC would do, man. Everyone in the NFC goes for it on fourth down, fake punt. You're running out of time. Oh, I don't know what to pick. I'm never caught in fourth down situations.
No move to pull Carr and the offense off.
If you hold X, your people run up to the line faster. It's all right. I'll decline it. I got you, dude. It's only preseason, man.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and five.
Mm-hmm.
They'll go for it. It's Carr. And this is
nice.
And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. They were caught in no man's land that time, but the decision to go for it, that was the right one. It's a first down.
Does he have that trait? Because people will literally have a trait called drops passes.
This offense,
I had two people on my team
now
that had that,
and
I don't know. Sometimes they'll go up and catch it over double coverage. Other times they'll drop a wide open slant route or something.
They run it with Jackson. And down inside the 35, he goes to the 32-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with
what happens when an unstoppable force meets an immovable object.
As this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line.
You get Bo Jackson
and
Mean Joe Green. I know you did. That is something Bo would do too. I think Joe Green's about the only person on my team that can tackle Bo.
Looking to throw on second down.
Oh, I bit again.
Nowhere to turn here. He's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon. And guess what? I think they're just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield and get after the quarterback.
Been such an impressive first half to get that lead.
I hate, like...
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Just throw the ball.
From the gun, it's Carr. He's going to let this one go deep.
Oh, what?
And
oh!
And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Philip Dorsett.
I know. I was holding the swap button, but he was like,
and the Raiders have cut it back to within a score. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, I'd be in practice sessions.
Oh, I almost got him.
From the receivers, that meant fly route, go. Look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
So 5 yards.
Oh, no, I hit the kicker.
Lucky it wasn't 15.
No doubt about it, because they protect the kickers and the guys holding the ball almost as much as they protect quarterbacks in the pocket. They don't want those types of
injuries. That's such a stupid flag, man. I remember the first time I got flagged for that, I was so mad. What do you mean you can't hit the kicker?
A touchdown now as the kickoff's away.
Put your hands in the air.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Steelers' offense now, they get ready to head back on the field.
Oh, right
now, no. They're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
All right, here we go. Green!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll wind up with about six up past the 30 to the 31.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates.
I think they're splitting carries. I don't know.
For a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
I remember last season I split carries between Ty Montgomery and Mark Ingram.
Second and four from the 31.
Yeah, he is.
Green 39! Green 39!
It's actually not too bad because that means at that point we had the same quarterback and halfback.
Now Jackson on second down. And now he'll tuck it and run. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. The Steelers able to pick up 18 yards there.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
They go play action here on first down. Flushed out right. Now he'll let it go deep right. That's caught inside.
Oh, what a tackle.
And he's set up down around the 15-yard line. That one goes for 36 yards.
In our pregame meeting,
we actually picked him up from the Raiders, yeah.
And wanting him to make his throws from the pocket because they knew he was pretty dangerous if he got outside. And he just showed it right there.
Yeah.
Pretty good arm, too.
Here we go.
They'll run it now out of the gun.
Oh, he tripped on a ladybug.
After only a yard, taking it down to the 14.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out.
Oh, no way.
That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
Gun, gun! Gun, gun!
Yeah, oh, that guy.
Jackson to throw on second down. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And here he'll get it down to the 7. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
Mm-hmm.
And the perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an
incompletion. Oh, so it was already there.
Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync.
Yeah.
Stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
On third down, it's Freeman. Oh. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. He needed two.
He has four rushes for 0 yards.
Fourth down and a yard.
Another scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play.
I don't fake these, man.
He looks like one of those guys.
That's too scary. Yeah, I just renamed him Hot Trash. he's Hot Trash.
And this one is right through. And they will move up by 10 now. 17-7. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because.
Yeah, he's living up to his namesake.
Situation, right? Made him kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
Here comes Philip Dorsett now to return it. And he'll bring it a few past the 20
Whoa.
To the 23-yard line. Now it looks like we've got a Raider here.
Oh, shit.
Definitely the last thing you want to see in a preseason game. We'll be right back.
I tried. Last time you said you wanted to return it, so I figured.
Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their own 23.
Oh man, you just hurt his confidence points right there.
Working from the gun, it's Carr. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end pass rush. They've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away. And
the NFC loves slants, too.
Together, the front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
And once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Back to the air on second down. It's Carr.
Oh, no.
Carr lost it. Fumble. And the offense will cover this one up, but they'll be pushed back inside their own 10.
Oh, my goodness.
A place like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction.
I'm gonna put my tackling on conservative, man. I don't want to hurt nobody. This is only preseason now.
After the sack, they'll come up now, third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
2 minutes to go here in the first half. Back to Heinz Field after this. The Raiders on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be third and forever. No run call here. They'll look to throw instead. And this is going to be incomplete. Well, shame on them, Coach Davis. They went against your advice. They threw the football, and now they're backed up to punt this away.
They're actually fortunate. They went against my advice, but they didn't turn it over, right? No takeaway for the defense. They'll punt it now. They probably could have gained a few yards if they ran it, though, and helped out with field position.
Yeah. There's nothing going on over there, man. Stick with the play.
And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one.
Oh, my God.
This will be fielded at the 17. Well, that looked for a second like he might take it all the way, but as it stands, it's still a massive return. And the Steeler offense, they're set up nicely as they take over. And the Steelers set to take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're 1-2-3s that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But also,
hey, he finally has a yard.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd-and-9 situation.
You could put a spy on the field.
The Raiders call on a nickel set for 3rd down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. 2 yards on the pick up there. It's 4th down.
You can pick whichever linebacker you want. If you press X on him and then flick the right stick, it puts him in a spy.
Steel City with the Steelers on top. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports halftime report.
When you press X on your dude, it actually comes up with a bunch of different adjustments you can do to him specifically. So you can like man him up against the running back or whatever.
Expect to see a good number of backups going forward as we are back and underway here in preseason week 2. And they will not get a chance to return this one.
Yeah,
as it's
that was
the end
it's
zone
good
for a touchback. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that
that's just what you need.
spend the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half.
Oh, look, my lowest rated player on my team is my backup QB.
We're going to see him when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
I don't know, man. He just, I guess my dude thought he smelled nice or something. He wanted to figure out if that was at Dolce & Gabbana.
Sometimes this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
He's a rookie, man. He's still got a little bit of jitters. Struggle,
especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just
I don't really like power backs, just because like they're not fast, but
that's a good start for him.
You know, get what you get.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And this will be taken across midfield and into Raider territory. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19!
Oh, that was worthless motion in that guy. I thought he was going to come across the formation. He just scooted over like 3 yards.
And they'll go with a ground attack.
Oh.
And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
First chance for the backup here to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah.
Oh, yeah.
That's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Yeah, we got him. Oh. No one got it.
Now they try the right side here.
And play will go nowhere. Dude, I don't know what it is, but my running backs just love your players, man. They just can't get away from them.
I like the
strategy. They're too cute.
Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter.
Oh, dude, my coach right now is sweating bullets. He's so mad. Mike Hambone pacing up and down the sideline. He is not happy right now. Yes.
On play action,
oh no! No!
Steps away to his left.
Throw to that guy.
Looking right side, and he's got a man. It's Flowers. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one goes for 24 yards.
That happens to the best of us.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 27.
Come on now, don't be like that. You're not. This is literally your second game. You sell yourself so short.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, yeah. But the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
All right, everyone, get back out there.
Now let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90!
Now, I've never tried this play before, so, I mean, this is probably one of the best times to try it.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. He's able to get six, a nice pickup down to the 21.
Looks to me like maybe
I don't know if Madden has those, honestly.
Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look
at the
scoreboard.
I heard that was super good when
the Steelers
when it was out.
Third down, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 4.
All right, here we go. 3-19! 3-19!
They'll drop the throw. He can run for it, and he will.
He's so slow.
To avoid the contact. 8 yards that
he
time.
Is definitely not Lamar, man.
Is a first down.
Look at how nice slow he is, man. He looks like a young Big Ben.
Guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations.
He just like falls.
You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to get him inside the five here, just inside the five to about the four. Just what you want on a first down run.
My game
yards.
Is suggesting me to throw a Hail Mary right now. Like, I'm not even kidding. It says it's effective 26% of the time and gains 0.8 average yards in goal line. And why would I use that? That's exactly the yardage I need too.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue lining. Blue lining.
He'll drop to throw. And it's caught.
Get in.
And he's gonna take it in for a
stupid
touchdown.
That's what I'm talking about, man. This team.
4 yards out. And the Steelers are gonna add on to their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical. That's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now, starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This one taken from the 7. And he's up across the 25 and down.
He's fine. He's fine. He's getting
line.
Up.
So here comes the Raiders offense.
A little bit of Neosporin.
He'll
be just fine.
Of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot
of
the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the
second half? All right, I don't know any of these people out on the field right now.
12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use. Just something to get you off to a quick start.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Excuse me.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Oh, goodness. Oh, wow.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Look at this tight end on the
nice
corner.
Pass.
And able to rip off.
Look at this quarterback, dude. 2 for 2, 35 yards.
The 40. That one goes for 24 yards.
Oh no. And he only had 2 throws. Hey, that might be a good idea. Get some picks for him or something, you know?
Back to back good plays. Have him on the move on first down.
Ooh.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10.
From here, it looks like it's Talbot.
Back to throw now on second and 10. And he's
what a catch.
Over the middle, complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
Right up the seam. Good pass.
Nice gain of 21 yards. Took till the second half, but finally a red zone opportunity here. They've got a first and 10 at the 17.
Here we go.
fires again to Richard. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Looking to throw. And this is going to be intercepted. Able to get there and pick it.
Yeah, he's just trying to throw this ball into the hole in the zone.
Oh, it was a comeback.
Open and close quickly, especially in the middle of the field. So if the timing's not right, we'll see interceptions like that one right there.
They'll run it now.
Go this way.
A little juke. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he will lose
your wheels on the bus. Go ground and pound.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. Tackle made by Tyus Bowser.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the
onus
on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
And the Steelers on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6.
Now let's go. Green 39. Green 39. I get
a headache. Back to throw. Throwing middle, and it's complete. It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does. Because
I always play coverage on the back end.
Spot when he gets his drop back completed.
I don't know. I feel at home when I play defense. Like, I feel like I'm a defense first player.
He's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
Hey, they're just super close, man, you know. It's football. You get to really get to learn your teammate.
And this will be taken across midfield and into Raider territory. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one will swallow
that dude's name is Toomer.
This big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease.
Oh, shit. I take that back. I apologize.
Now let's go.
Sweet. It's super hard to find superstars in the draft. Kyle just finds them left and right, though. I don't know how he does it. Yeah, last year he drafted a superstar safety, and this year he drafted a superstar quarterback. It's like, what, dude? How?
They'll need to do better this time. It's 3rd and 6.
He's got the inside scoop. Yeah. Sam, oh no. Oh no. I thought this was going to be good, but I'm wrong. Oh no. I'm surprised he didn't punch you, man. Oh, that's his baby. Oh, yeah, I've seen that a time or two.
He'll look to throw. Flush to his right. Going right side here, and that's complete. First target, first catch, and a first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's
I don't even know who that guy is.
Right,
this is the longest my backup quarterback has ever seen the field.
Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
He literally never plays. He yelled Patriot on my screen.
Hey, watch that, watch that. Check Mike 54.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And down inside the 35, he goes to the 32-yard line.
Sounds like he says good try.
First down, and it'll leave him with a second and two. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down fourth quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we?
The nerve because of some people.
Every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, bent over, hands on
oh
their knees.
My God.
The offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running.
He got walloped.
Now.
It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Calling
good
no
tackle
game there, and it leads to a fourth down.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
We got him now.
Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the left hash, it's an even 50-yard attempt. And this one is right down.
Oh, it's got the leg.
And that will push this lead up to 20 now. So it's three more points.
See, if I can make a 50, you can make a 62.
Here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points. But this widens it out, as you said. And now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. So out come the Raiders. They've lost this one. Their offense has
struggled.
Now? Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in a game this and you knew it was lost.
Yeah,
it was
they
over,
just
right?
And a coach, I don't know. Doing comeback routes is tricky. The timing is just real weird.
I want something executed well before we get out of here.
Whoa.
And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to
wait
build
a minute.
On, get it done.
That how oh no, okay.
Say,
Tumor
we'll
is your superstar.
Forward.
Okay.
I call that play a success.
About
to
say you got
nice
Bo Jackson and this superstar running back.
Second down, a very solid gain on that play.
Ball on the 30, they'll come up with a second and 5.
Oh no.
They'll set up to throw.
That's the drops passes right there.
Pass. You know,
that's drops passes.
In this game and
get rid of him.
Frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a second.
Yeah,
that's
the stuff
on.
I'm talking about.
They just play better and better.
The Raiders on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This will be 3rd and 5. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw.
Good pass.
He comes back with one complete. And he will have a first down as they get
him. You're like, do I want to throw it?
Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Once you know that guy drops passes, you start second guessing yourself. Should I throw it? Or is he just going
to
drop it?
And they'll run it here. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack.
It's just weird not seeing
the
Joe out there.
Guys in the middle of this D has got to be priority one.
Green is like, he's like a cornerstone in my defense, man. And he's not out there. I feel lost.
Watch it now, Barney.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10.
Good pass.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
He just needs to get that run after catch next time.
Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
The Raiders on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be 3rd and 6. He'll look to throw.
Oh, screen.
And a Steeler pressure too much here. He's
oh, there's Green. Right as I say that.
Whistles for a timeout. So they'll stop clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
He's going to let it fly. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked off near the 42.
And that's game.
Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, where they're predicted to
here
finish,
go.
Talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done.
Juan Blanco.
Really good about that victory.
There you go.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the
God.
Best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughan. This has been
terrible.
A presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The Steelers are winners as we say so long. From
that's almost where I'm at, man. No, the solar minimums, yeah. I still wouldn't believe him. Oh yeah, but Lamar had not. Oh, I need to shut down the broadcast. I forgot. I'm still streaming right now. How I shut this down. Sharing and broadcast settings. I don't know how to turn this off. I'm on YouTube. How do I get this notification off my screen? I want to see if this is an option. Stop broadcasting.